Wrestling fans, we have in the ring now with us the all-rich Skandor Akbar and California Nature Boy Buddy Landell, and they say they have a very important message.
First of all, Landell, where are the results that you promised me? I want you to remember who you're dealing with, the man, the general. I expect results, and I expect you to honor your commitment, young man.
Mr. Akbar, I'd just like to say that, you know, some of my friends say that Arab money is, you know, some of that oil money is blood money. Now, don't get me wrong. I would never say that, and I personally would never hold anything derogatory towards you or your country. But, you know, you have paid me a considerable amount of cash, and that's all right and all that. But, you know, where I come from, stuff up front talks, and I would... You know, a little bit more incentive what I need. I need a little bit more incentive, if you know what I'm talking about, to produce...
I understand what you're talking about, Landell.
I thought you would. Grease the palm if you know what I'm talking about.
Americans are the same. I know you understand what solid gold Rolex watch valued at $10,000 to $12,000 American dollars, which means nothing to me, but it is yours, on one condition. You deliver, and I want results next week, understood?
That's exactly what I'm talking about. That's right. Mr. Akbar, you have just given me the incentive to do what we have agreed to do upon. Thank you very much.
One more thing. It's quite evident in the Mid-South that the general, the boss man, is back. Ted DiBiase is back. The Rat Pack is back. And if there's any doubts in your minds, you can ask Hacksaw Duggan.
And now we'll go back to the desk with Joel Watts and Jim Ross.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we mentioned here last week, we would have a press conference here on Mid-South Wrestling. General Skandor Akbar has called this press conference. So at this time, I'll turn these proceedings over to General Skandor Akbar.
Well, I have an important announcement to make. I would like to announce that I have purchased the contract of Hercules Hernandez from James E. Cornette. Now, Mr. Cornette, I'm sure that you have received my check and that the contract is in order.
I have. As a matter of fact, the general made me a very, very generous offer. I did call and check. The check has cleared my bank, so I do have the contract here. You know, the reason that I hired Hercules Hernandez to be my bodyguard was because of the threat of Hacksaw Jim Duggan to my personal safety. But after what's happened to Duggan lately, he's afraid to say boo to a goose. There's no reason to have a bodyguard. The general made me a very generous offer, and General, here is the contract signed, sealed, and delivered.
And as you can see that I'm paying tribute to this mighty athlete by making him an honorary sheik. And that means, Mr. Hernandez, business at hand.
Maybe I can get my own harem or something.
Wait, just a moment. There's a job to be done. Business at hand. That will come later. Now, with the acquisition of Hercules, now Sheik Hernandez, that makes the general's army more powerful than ever.
I got him for you, baby. I got him. I told you I'd deliver him, baby. I got him for you. I told you, brother.
Well, young man, I'm capable of doing my own dealing, my own transactions. By the way, what are you doing with that watch on? You know where that watch is supposed to go. And I told you last week, and I'm telling you today emphatically, that by the end of today's program, that you better have results, and you know where that watch goes.
No problem. I'm just keeping it polished, Mr. Akbar. Everything's under control. If I tell you, if the Nature Boy says he can deliver something, then go to the bank on it. It'll be here.
That's certainly better. As I said before, Killer Khan, the missing link, Sheik Hernandez, and my associate Ted DiBiase, and Buddy Landell. The general's army is more powerful than ever, and I intend to dominate Mid-South like never before. And anybody that stands in the way of the general, shame on you, because I will steamroll you, and you will pay severe consequences. From now on, you will call me Mr. Mid-South.
Well, that concludes this press conference with General Skandor Akbar. Now let's go back to Cowboy Bill Watts and Boyd Pierce. Ladies and gentlemen, this match on Mid-South Wrestling is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First, I'd like to introduce in the red corner at 260 pounds from Kansas City, Hacksaw Butch Reed. What are you doing here?
I have to talk to my man, Hacksaw Butch Reed. It's very important. Just wait a minute.
We have a match. Ladies and gentlemen, highly irregular.
I am the man, boy. What do you mean? Hey, don't you know who I am, Buddy Landell? I'm surprised you bought something like that to me. Don't you know that I run out the dog? Don't you know that I beat Master G in a polio after he tried to break my leg? I come back and whoop the hell out of him. And you gonna tell me about somebody who wants me? Hey, man, I don't need nobody because I am the man. I am the number one man in this South. I stand alone.
But you're real good. You're real good. You've improved so much since I've taught you everything that I know, and you've really improved a lot since you've been
you
with me.
You tell me what, boy? You tell me what? Let me tell you something, sucker. I taught you everything you know. The only reason why that I let you hang around, boy, is because I just tolerate you and I feel sorry for you. You just like a parasite. You just like a leech. You just like one of them little old fish that follow the shark around, eating up the puppies, boy. Get out of here. I gotta run. Get out of here.
This is for our career. Come here, look. Butch, a solid $9,000 presidential Rolex watch, brother. It's for you, Butch. It's for you. I'm trying to do this for our career. Mr. Ackman said to give this to you, brother.
So this is what it is, huh? So this is what the Rolex watch is all about, right? You're going to deliver me to Scandal Ackbar? Let me tell you something, bloodsucker. I don't need you. I don't need Scandal Ackbar. I don't need nobody. Because Butch Reed, the hacksaw, the brick house walks alone. And you know what I think of you and this Rolex and Scandal Ackbar? Huh? That's what I think of you, boy. That's what I think of you, boy. You understand? That's exactly what I think of you. What are you doing, Butch? Get out of here. I got to beat somebody up. Get out of here. Hey, Butch, turn your back. Put your hands on me.
Wait come just on, a minute, man. Gentlemen.
Hold on, Reed. Hold on, Reed. Hold on. Let's talk. Let's talk.
Yeah, let's maintain some.
Let's talk, Reed. Let's talk. We didn't come to fight. Let's talk. Let's talk business. I made a mistake. I should have come to you personally, Butch Reed. I know that you're a man of your own. And I didn't realize the animosity between you and Landell existed. But now, wait a minute, wait a minute. Now, you're a diplomatic individual, I'm a gracious individual. And I'm prepared to make you an offer. I am prepared to make you the offer of your lifetime.
Listen to him. Hey, just shut up. I'm listening.
You join forces with the general, and you won't have to worry about anything. Because I intend to dominate Mid-South. I intend to steamroll all opposition. So let's have your answer.
Well, let me tell you something. Scandal Ackbar, I don't need you. I don't need your blood sucker, buddy. Butch Reed stands alone.
Think for just a moment. All right, think for just one moment. I'll give it to you like a man that you are. Let me give it to you like a man. Either you're with us or you're against us. You make your own mind up.
Well, I'll tell you what, Scandal Ackbar. I guess I'm against you.
Boy, Paris, it's pandemonium. This Reed is, he's standing alone, but he's against too much. He's against too much firepower. Even as bad as Hacksaw Butch Reed is, too much firepower. So the general said either you're with us or you're against us. Oh, there's Hacksaw Dugan. Hacksaw Dugan, and he's got a 2x4. He's got a 2x4, and it's getting scarce in that ring. Hacksaw Dugan. The big man is back, and he's got a 2x4. He came to Butch Reed's rescue. Hacksaw Dugan. Listen to this crowd. This is something going on. It's getting hot and heavy, Boyd. Boyd, we'll try to get a chance to talk to one of these guys. Duggan's putting a hand forward to Reed. Boyd, we'll try to get to talk to him.
Well, we'll try to talk to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with two proud men, two tough men. Both of you stand alone. Butch Reed, I heard you say you stand alone, and Duggan, I know you stood alone. But what I've seen about Akbar and DiBiase, the Rat Pack, or the Army as he calls them, I don't know if any one man can stand alone. And during the commercial break, I tried to get you to come over here. You've consented to come over here. I think you guys need to kind of tell everybody your feelings about this situation.
Probably Bill Watts, after we get done here, me and Butch need to probably go somewhere and sit down and talk down man-to-man, eye-to-eye, and just get a few things straight. But if anybody, after two long years of banging heads with somebody, you learn a lot about somebody. You may not agree, I may not agree, let me rephrase that. I may not agree with a lot of things Butch Reed does, and I'm sure he doesn't agree with a lot of things I do. But I respect the man, because I've been right up there in that circle with him, and I've gone nose to nose. He gave me his best shot, and I gave him mine. And he came back for more, and I came back for more. So I respect you for that, Butch Reed, and I respect you for standing on your own. Now, I don't blame you for keeping your eye on me, and I guarantee you I want to keep my eye on you. But there's a force coming here in Mid-South that we haven't seen before. It's like a black plague, a cancerous growth, the Skandar Akbar, Ted DiBiase, Hercules Hernandez, a few other people joining together. And right, maybe we need to get off camera, and maybe we need to set up a few things and straighten things out around here in Mid-South.
You hear what the man said, Bill Watts? He said the whole thing right there. He said respect for your fellow man. We done fought each other tooth and nail. Matter of fact, I done run out the junkyard dog and I done beat up Master G after knee surgery, and this is the only man right now that I get to give respect to as being one of the toughest suckers around here other than me. But it seems like Butch Reed has done lost some of his respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, and now it's time. Now it's time for Butch Reed to start giving his respect. I don't care how I got to do it. Jim Diggin,
you know, baby, show me that fire, baby. You'll be with me. I don't need this slumber.
And brother, I don't think it's one of us is gonna take out them suckers. Them no good dogs up there. So if we get to unite, then that's what the hell we'll do.
You got it, what it takes. We'll do it, baby. I don't need this slumber. I need a fired up hacksaw.
I think drastic measures need drastic action. Right now, let's go to the ring announcer, Jim Ross, for the next.